Morning students, nice to see you. Yeah, we were discussing about the examples. Very good, very good. So yesterday we discussed up to two examples, isn't it? So we are going to think about the third example, right? Express. See, the first question we have seen find the value. The second example we have seen simplify. You must be able to understand the difference. Find the value, that means you will get an answer there, a number, okay, a number. But simplify means you have to change the procedure, that the total system must be changed from bigger to the smaller one. Now here, express. Express means you have to represent that one. Okay, express each of the following with positive exponents. So they have given you negative exponents, you have to convert them into positive exponents. Okay, just expressing, no need to find the value or anything, you just express. So coming to the first question, 4 power minus 7. As you see this question, immediately you can identify the formula. What is the formula? Very good, Amma. A power minus m is equal to 1 by a power m, isn't it? So this is 1 by 4 power 7, that's it. No need to find the value of 4 power 7, not necessary. It is just asked to express. Very good, Amma, very good. Coming to the second one, 1 by 5 to the power of minus 4. 1 by 5 to the power of minus 4. So you can observe the same formula here. 1 by 5 power 4. Since a power minus m is equal to 1 by a power m. Isn't it? So as it is 1 by and 1 by. So a fraction in the denominator will be reversed. So it becomes 5 power 4 by 1, which is nothing but 5 power 4. Okay? No need to find the value of 5 power 4. Very good, very good. Right. Now we come to the third question. The third question is 4 upon 7 whole power minus 3. Coming to the third question, 4 upon 7 whole power minus 3. Is it clear? Right, Nana? So you observe here, this is a formula what we have learned earlier. A by B whole to the power of minus m. Can you tell me what is the formula for this one? Excellent, Ma, excellent, very good. B by A whole to the power of m. And this will be reversed and the power will be changed into positive. So similarly, you take this one, 7 upon 4 whole to the power of 3. 7 upon 4 whole to the power of 3. You can directly use the formula. Or as it is given in the textbook for you, you make the distribution 4 power minus 3 by 7 power minus 3. So how did you make this one? Using the formula, a by b whole power m is equal to a power m upon b power m. Okay? Now here you change them as 1 by 4 power 3 by 1 by 7 power 3. Is it clear? This is by using the formula. What is the formula we are using here? Very good, Amma. A power minus m is equal to 1 by a power m. Now this can be again changed as 1 by 4 power 3 into 7 power 3 by 1, where you get the value as 7 cube by 4 cube, which can be changed as 7 by 5 whole power 3. Yes, yes, very good, very good, Nana. You get the same values, you get the same formulas, but we are just changing the formula. If in the examinations, this question is given for half mark, you can directly use this one. If it is given for more than half, or maybe 1 or 2 marks, you can do this method. Okay? Or else you can do this method, use the correct formula. It is clear. Right, Nana, right. Very good. Now, let's go to the fourth question. Fourth question in the example 3, Nana. Fourth question in example 3. So, what is the question? Yes, very good. 7 power minus 4 upon 7 power minus 6. This is what? You can observe this same model. So you can use the formula. Okay. Now you can just change them into the 1 by 7 power 4 upon 1 by 7 power 6. 1 by 7 power 4 upon 1 by 7 power 6. So you can change it as 1 by 7 power 4 into 7 power 6 by 1. Isn't it? Is equal to 7 power 6 by 7 power 4. You can stop the answer at this position. It's clear. But in the exam, in the question, it is simplified for you. But they didn't ask you to simplify. Just as asked you to express as positive powers. So we changed them into positive powers. If you want, you can extend this question using the formula a power m by a power n is equal to a power m minus n. But it is not compulsory to extend the answer. 7 power 6 minus 4 is equal to 7 power 2. Here, what formula did we use, ma? Very good. Ma, I may forget writing the formulas. Yesterday I said you. I may forget the writing the formula, but you have to remind that one. You have to write the formulas wherever you have changed them, wherever you have used them. Okay? Right. Next, going to example 4. Okay, Nana? Did you understand everybody? Very good, very good. Now we are going to example 4. So what did they give in the example 4? What did they ask you to find there? To find or to simplify or to express? So you have to understand the question clearly. Express 27 power minus 4 as a power with base 3. So keep a star for this question. The fourth question is x power 20 express 27 power minus 4 as power with base 3. As a power with base 3, that means you have to change this base. So this is the base and this is the power or exponent, isn't it? So you have to change the base. So how do you write 27? So you make the prime factorization of 27, 3 9s and 3 3s. How many 3s did you get there? 3. You're right, very good. 3 power 3 whole to the power of minus 4. You can observe the formula a power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n. Excellent, excellent. Now you can change this one as 3 to the power of 3 into minus 4, where you can change as 3 power minus 12. 3 power minus 12. If you observe this negative in the power, a power minus m is equal to 1 by a power m. Now you change this one as 1 by 3 power 12. Okay? Did you understand everybody? Right. Okay. Next example is 5 example. Example 5, 6, 7 we will discuss in the next class. Okay? Practice these two examples and all the 4 once again. Bye.